This experiment enables us to find the formula of copper oxide by reducing it in a stream of hydrogen. The hydrogen removes the oxygen and forms water, which will be steam at the temperature of the experiment. This is the apparatus we use, a Pyrex reduction tube, which is essentially a boiling tube with a small hole in the end to allow excess hydrogen to escape. Before starting the experiment, it's important to familiarise yourself with how to use a hydrogen cylinder. This valve here, the cylinder valve, is operated by a spanner. Turning the spanner allows hydrogen gas into the pressure reduction valve gear here. This valve is the pressure reduction valve. Turn it on and we'll see a reading of that gauge there. And finally, the flow rate of the hydrogen is regulated using this needle valve here. We first need to weigh the empty reduction tube. The balance used must read to at least 2 decimal places. We now place about 3 grams of copper oxide, which is really a couple of spatulafuls of the powder, into the reduction tube. Try to place this in the centre of the tube. If it's too close to the hole end, there's a risk of the hydrogen flow blowing some of it out. If it's too close to this end, then there's a risk of heating the bung while we heat the copper oxide. Having put the copper oxide into the tube, we re-weigh it. The copper oxide should be dry. Old stock may need to be dried in an oven or desiccator. We now use the needle valve to adjust flow of hydrogen. A rate of flow that you can just feel on your cheek is about right. Now place the hydrogen delivery tube in the end of the reduction tube. The next step is to light the hydrogen, but it's important to wait for about a minute to make sure all the hydrogen has flushed out any air from the reduction tube. Otherwise, you could get an explosive mixture in there. For the lighting process, we have safety screens to protect the demonstrator and the audience. Once something like a minute has passed, we now can light the hydrogen. And adjust the flame until it's about 2 centimetres or so high. At this point, there's no more explosion risk, so we can dispense with the safety screens. Now we heat the copper oxide using a roaring Bunsen flame and using the hottest part of the flame, which is just beyond the blue cone. At this point, a number of interesting observations can be made, and these will probably need to be pointed out to the audience. Droplets of water will condense on the cooler part of the reduction tube near the hole. These will evaporate as the tube gets hotter. The height of the flame will drop as some of the hydrogen is used up, reacting with the oxygen in the copper oxide. The flame may develop a green coloration caused by copper atoms vaporized into the flame. Use the Bunsen burner to chase the glow along the length of the oxide until all the black copper oxide has been changed to pinkish copper. This will take up to a minute. When no trace of black remains, continue to heat for at least a further minute to ensure that all the oxide on the inside of the heap has reacted. If in any doubt, continue heating for longer. Make sure any condensation has evaporated. When you're confident that all the copper oxide has been reduced, the flame is back to its original height, you can stop heating. It's now important to leave the apparatus exactly as it is with the hydrogen flowing. This is to prevent air from diffusing back into the reduction tube and converting some of the hot copper back to the oxide. Continue until the tube is cool enough to touch comfortably. We now blow out the flame, remove the hydrogen delivery tube and turn off the cylinder. And reweigh the tube, which now contains copper. The copper looks pinkish and not particularly metallic. If students are not convinced that it actually is metallic copper, it's possible to get some of it out of the tube and use a circuit tester to show that it is in fact metallic. Finally, we have to turn off the hydrogen cylinder. We first close the cylinder valve with the spanner, and we then need to use the pressure reduction valve. We turn it on and the needle valve on to vent any hydrogen from the valve gear. Finally, turn off the pressure reduction valve and also the needle valve.